Over 26% of all undergraduate students are raising dependent children. Women make up 71% of that. They work, go to school, and raise their children. Safe to say, they are a superwoman of our generation. Morgan Wilkinson, a 23-year-old student parent at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, says it isn't easy.
Luckily, I have a wonderful support system, but you know, your initial reaction is basically panic. You don't know what you're gonna do. You don't know what this means for you. But luckily, you know, I had Charlie, my husband, and I had my family, so it completely changed my life. I no longer lived my life for myself. I live it for him now and my family. But, you know, initially, you know, if in school terms, I had to take time off. I didn't have a choice, so I had to take time off from school to have him, and luckily I was able to take time off from everything, so work and everything too, for a couple months right after. But from that moment on, it was basically, you know, how do I fit in what I can now, and then, you know, kind of live each day by day and try to make the best out of the situation that I could.
Jan Dietz is a director of the Women's Center at UNL. The university has only documented 13 student parents, and Dietz says the stereotype of being a young parent may keep others from being recognized.
Well, I think adult women out in the workforce worry about this sometimes too. Should I tell the person I'm interviewing with that I'm pregnant? Because then they're going to assume that I'll probably quit or whatever. So there are stereotypes about parenting.
There's kind of a stigma on it that, well, she's pregnant, she's in college, she's probably not going to finish college, you know. So, and my main goal is to make Brady's life the best life. So with that, you know, trying to break the stereotype, if you would say that, just trying to keep going and as slow as I need to go, but to keep going.
The truth of the matter is that student parents are some of the most organized people ever. They, you know, they know what they have to do. You put the baby in their little jumper, but they sleep in their clothes for the next day, so that then you can just put them in the car and get them to childcare, and then get to your classes, and then do all of those things. So you know what you need to do, and you've scheduled when you're going to study, and you have the backup systems, plan B, C, D for childcare. You have to do that in order to be able to do this. So in fact, parents are some of the most organized students ever, and the most determined, again. And I think that is part of the stereotype. You get the message that it's going to be really hard for you to do this, and so you may not be able to do it. Well, I think it's going to be really hard, but you're going to do it because you're really determined to do it.
Well, you know, college has never, to me, in my mind, been an option of no or yes. I've always known that I wanted to do, and my dream has always been to be an elementary school teacher. So I knew I would be finishing. You know, when you start as a freshman, you think, oh, 4 years, I'm done. And that's not really the case for a lot of people, even in my situation, even if they're not in my situation. So it's never been an option for me not to finish.
After taking 3 semesters off of school to deliver Brady, Morgan expects to graduate in a year and a half. The Women's Center is full of resources and is available for any students who need someone to talk to about the beginning of your life as a parent. But Morgan has a little advice too.
So you're as strong as you think that you are. So, you know, if you're thinking like, I can't do this, you can do more than you think you can do. So I don't ever think that, you know, and to me, of course, at the beginning, I looked at it as an obstacle, but now, I mean, I can't even imagine my life not going in this direction. You know, it's just kind of how it's become, what it's become. And if you make the most of it, then it can be the biggest blessing in your life.